Okay, so last time we were on the boat in Booty Bay and we logged out there. I actually finished the trip all the way to Gadgetzan. I said I was going to do the walk, but as it turned out, we had the flight plan. I guess I forgot that we've been here. So all I did is I took the boat over here, landed in Ratchet, and just flew from Ratchet straight down here and then logged out. So that's as far as I got. Let's check our mail real quick. Where have I been? I put a video up since then. Some auction successful stuff. I'm gonna go ahead and delete some of these junk mail from the gold spammers there. And sold some wild. Whoops, don't delete that. Sold some wild vine. Elemental earth sold for about 250 a piece, which is nice. And some more junk. Okay, so I want to put. There's no rumors or anything, but I want to briefly discuss while I'm running around here in Gadgetzan grabbing some quests. I want to briefly mention what's going on with Legion. So if you watch my channel, you know that I have a few Legion videos up, probably four or five at the time of this video being up. This quest here, we're gonna kill some Dune Maul Ogres. Very easy quest for us, I believe. Hold on a second. Might be a little high level, but I think we can do this quest. So I have some Legion videos up, and I just want to say, just like point blank, I am not giving up on playing vanilla WoW or giving up on legacy videos or anything like that. I honestly, what has happened is, first of all, I am a little disheartened, I guess the word disheartened, about the private server community right now, because I do think there is. Ooh, a wanted poster. Get some of this. Two quests, actually. I do think there is a lot of things going on in the community that are kind of frustrating, but that doesn't mean I don't like vanilla WoW anymore. I mean, I still love vanilla WoW, by the way. Tran Wreck quest. We get that in Booty Bay. We're gonna complete that. It's an easy little quest there. So, I'm not giving up on vanilla. Some things that are frustrating me about the community, more with the people that operate the servers, and my kind of gradual loss of confidence in Blizzard ever releasing their own servers. I still think it's a possibility, I certainly do, but I've lost confidence that it's gonna happen within the next year. I think we're at least, I mean, again, I said this a while, I said this like 6 months ago, but now I'm saying it again 6 months later. I still think we're at least a year away from any retail legacy servers. Even then, it's just optimism. It's super optimism. I'm recognizing more and more things as I, and this is why I'm playing Legion. So as I play Legion, I'm starting to understand better what Blizzard's vision is for WoW, for the future of WoW. And I am starting to see why, more so than I could have seen if I didn't play Legion, why maybe it isn't feasible for Blizzard anymore, or why it's no longer on their radar, rather. Not that it's not feasible, certainly they could do it, but why it's just absolutely not on their radar. I'm starting to get a better grasp of that. So that's the kind of the coming full circle here. One of the major reasons I'm playing Legion is to get a better understanding of where WoW has gone. Because I can talk about how I like vanilla WoW so much for days, but I can't say why I do or do not like Legion, because I've never played Legion. I have no experience in Legion. So I thought it would maybe be a little bit less. So I'm trying to think about some quests here. We will not be doing the Thirsty Goblin right now. That quest is a little bit high level for us. I know where it's at, it would just take too long. And I think we will skip the Dune Maul compound right now. I think we're gonna put that away for the moment. But
time is money.
ooh, we got a lot of quests here. So the Divinomatic Rod is actually a quest in Zul'Garub, so we don't need to grab that quest right now. We'll grab it when we want to go there. Waste Wander Justice we can take. And Wastewater Bounty Pouch. Okay, so we've got a lot of quests now. So there's just, I just don't know enough about Legion. And I honestly, if you watch the videos of my Legion videos, I'm not trying to bash Legion. I'm really spending a lot of time just thinking about, you know, how does Legion play? How does it feel? How does it compare to vanilla? And I'm spending most of my time kind of playing it, and I am enjoying it. To be honest, I am having fun. The first few videos, I was kind of like, eh, a little bit iffy on it. But over time, I've grown to enjoy it a little bit more. I'm still very new into it. I'm not even level 101 yet. I did a boost level 100, and I don't know. So I am enjoying it, but it's just a different game. It truly is. Going into it with the mindset that I'm going to treat it like vanilla WoW and try and bring over the concepts from vanilla WoW that I know and know very well into Legion has not worked. It just, it doesn't work. It's just not the same game. So, I don't really know, oh, what's going on here? I don't want to die to these guys. I'm going to go hide back. There's a little bit of world PvP going on here, a little bit of a mess. Maybe, where's this guy? Okay. How many people are online, by the way? 3,700, cool. Okay, good. Well, they're going to go do their thing. I'm leaving those guys alone. I don't want to deal with them. Sorry, I've been talking about this for 5 minutes. I haven't made a clear point. The point is, I'm playing Legion, having a little bit of fun with it. I am enjoying it, recognizing it's a very different game, so it's not going to replace vanilla WoW for me. And I'm learning a lot about how WoW has evolved over the years, for better or worse. And I just want to put to rest any concerns anyone has that I am giving up on vanilla servers or anything like that. I'm still going to play my Orc Warlock playthrough and still do occasional other videos when I have an idea that's interesting to me. If this server dies, if the Elysium family of servers dies, or specifically I'm on Anathema, if that dies, then I will go to Kronos 1, or Kronos, I guess it's just one server now, I'll go to Kronos, because I already have a Dwarf Priest there, and I'll pick up that guy again and finish him off to 60, hopefully, if this server shuts down. But otherwise, that's my plan as far as play sessions in vanilla, is stick to my Warlock, and unless something happens to the servers, or my account gets hacked and I lose everything or anything like that, otherwise I'll stay on this character, and then if not I'll switch to my Dwarf Priest and carry on with things there, and I'll be doing some Legion stuff. So unfortunately, yes, it probably does mean there'll be a little bit slower rate of vanilla videos because I'll be doing some Legion videos. Honestly, like, you know, for every Legion video I make, I could have made a vanilla video, and so I do apologize for the split there, and I do recognize this channel has grown largely because of vanilla videos, so I am not forgetting that. I'm not trying to abandon anyone. Now, we're doing this quest right now. We're dousing this widget, and we're gonna run away because these guys are high level. Yeah, like 47, two level 47, kind of big guys. We're just gonna pop this nifty stopwatch, and hopefully Tangmoth will survive, and if not, oh well, we can resummon him. I look pretty awesome, by the way, now, I think. I don't know about you guys, but I think it looks pretty good, pretty good. See, oh crap, we gotta keep going. Oh, nope, we're good. Anyway, so, that's the Legion bit. I won't be talking about Legion very much in any of these videos. I honestly prefer to talk about Vanilla WoW or other random thoughts I have. But I just wanted to share that for the time being. I'd let you guys know what's going on. If you have any questions, honestly, the easiest way to ever get a hold of me is my Twitter, Supasoka Gaming. Just tweet at me on there. I generally reply to people if you have a question, especially. And I try to be responsive. And anyway, so now we're gonna keep working on our questing. And we are, last episode, by the way, we got like nothing done. I looked back at that video and I was like, geez, I went through so many zones and barely did anything, it felt like. I don't know, we just tried some things, but none of them really worked. And I'm still, so the other thing is, I've had a cold for like a month. I mean, it's seriously been about over a month. It's been 4.5 weeks since I woke up with a sore throat, and I was really sick. I like lost my voice for like 3 or 4 days, couldn't talk at all. So obviously I wasn't making any videos. And then this was like 2.5 weeks ago at this point, maybe 3 weeks ago almost, when I lost my voice. I took a few days off work, rested a lot, and came back, and I was feeling a bit better. And I never got 100% better, but I was improved. You know, like getting better at least. But then about almost a week ago now, I woke up again with a sore throat and I got sick all over again. I didn't lose my voice. Not this time, thankfully, but I was like really cold. Like, I think I had a fever. I just didn't take my temperature, but I was like shivering cold all day. I could not get warm. We have a little space heater we use once in a while. I plugged it, like an electrical space heater. I plugged it into the wall and sat and squatted right in front of it and wrapped a blanket around myself for about 20 minutes. And still had like goosebumps. I was so cold. I don't know what was going on. It was not a not a fun day. And it was like a Friday or something. And yeah, I was pretty sick. And then my throat was hurting really bad. It was a little bit harder to swallow. So I was not having trouble eating, but like it hurt to eat and drink a little bit. So it was just, man, I don't know what's going on. But now I woke up yesterday feeling a lot better. Feeling better now. Still have a little bit like it feels like I've got junk in my throat sometimes, so if you hear me like clear my throat a little bit more than normal, I apologize for that. I know it's kind of an annoying noise to hear, but you know, it is what it is. Oh man, I almost forgot this quest. We gotta go down here. So we just turned in that first, what was that quest called? Let's talk about WoW a little bit now. I've been like rambling about Legion and me being sick, but now I'm back, so hopefully also that means videos are going to come up a little more frequently. It was like a, I think it was like almost a 10-day gap between vanilla videos this last set, and I apologize for that. Like, it was a combination of, basically what happened is, I normally would have made a vanilla video, I made a Legion video instead. I had plans to make a vanilla video the next day, and it would have been totally fine, but then I got sick, and then I couldn't make anything for a few days. So I was sitting there like, well, crap, now I've got a Legion video ready to go, but no vanilla video. So yeah, anyway, I'm glad I'm feeling better. My wife was sick too, she's feeling better, so thankfully we're on the mend. So we turned in the Noxious Lair investigation quest. That was a really fast quest. I did it just while I was like rambling in the background. That was with that little water thing we had to collect. And we've got like three different, Zul'Farrakh quests here. I went ahead and threw away one of them just now because we don't need that many, and we're gonna instead pick up this cool. I don't even know what this quest is called. Marvin Rivet Seeker. We have to get these Gazridian ornaments, right? Gazridian ornaments. Yeah. Not an awful staff, but not anything we're gonna probably use. But what we can get is this cool, we get this cool hat piece that, let me look at it here, it gives a little swirly thing here. It looks like something from Gnomeregan, honestly. It will show up on our tracking, it'll show up any Gazridian ornaments anywhere, so that's kind of nice. You'll see what I'm talking about, I'll show you. There's a bunch of them right down here. And I'm gonna make a, let's just go straight west. We have a lot of quests we can do now. Hold on a sec, I'm trying to figure out a few things. Your lines of communication. Oh yeah, that's right, I remember. There's like an undercity quest. Like, what undercity quest do we have? Is the one in Hinterlands that we didn't finish. So these Gazridian ornaments, they are all over the zone, and they're represented as little mounds of sand, and usually there's one like around this thing somewhere. I don't see one. I'm kind of surprised I'm not seeing one right now. Usually there's one over here, and down here there's this like ogre hill thing. Yeah, like right around here, and even this little thing here, there's a, oh, here we go. Sorry, here's an example of one. Gazridian, yeah. So you don't need this hat on to see these, but on your mini map, if you look up here, you'll see it actually pops up. Whoops, there we go, looted it, okay. So it actually shows on the minimap. It's sort of like something you can mine or an herb you could collect. So it makes it a little bit easier to spot them. You don't have to actually like actively look around you as much. You can just focus on looking. You can just like look at the minimap every now and then. And this quest is fairly easy. And there's about, I don't know, hundreds of these spawn locations throughout the zone. So I'm not really going to stop and pick up any that are in areas that are highly guarded. So like those, like that hyena back there was chasing us. I wasn't going to stop. Ooh, hold on a sec. What is that? Human mage? Eh. I am not gonna attack the mage. It would be fun, but I'll leave him alone. If he freezes me, though, okay. I was gonna say, if he frost novas me, I will turn and shoot him. Just because. Now, I'm running right through this ogre camp, and the reason why I'm doing that is because sometimes there's a rare spawn, usually right here to the left. Let's see if we can find him. I gotta swing around these guys. I'm trying not to aggro anything here. He's like a 47 elite, a 48 elite. I mean, he's pretty beefy, so I don't know if we'll be able to kill him. But I just want to scope him out. We do have a quest to kill these ogres. We did have a quest. We dumped it. It's just a little high level for what I want to do with this quest. Like, I just don't feel like messing with it. This guy's in a guild. Vanilla original. Okay, cool guild. All right, now I realized, running through those ogres, I actually went the wrong way, so that's unfortunate for me. We're gonna head back over this way, because I want to get these centipar insect parts. It's a fairly easy quest to do, and I think it's a chain quest. So we're just gonna go ahead and farm these up real fast. Yeah, it shouldn't be too difficult. I think, I'm having like a deja vu moment, and I think the reason why I am is because I think I very recently did this quest on my mage, on which I have on the PvE Elysium server, gnome mage. I think I did that with the gnome mage. That mage is like level, what is that mage now, like 54? I haven't played him in a few weeks actually, but it's like the last thing I did with him is I happened to come over here and I was just like having some, I was messing around into Nerus with some quests that I had skipped, and it was an iron deposit, and went ahead and did that quest, even though it was kind of low level for that mage, but it was totally worth it, I think. Now, these guys, this area is a little bit dangerous, so we want to put on our hat, like our actual hat with stats, so we get a little more intellect, and more importantly, the shadow damage, because I don't want to mess around with these guys. Here we go, 49. Yeah, these guys are going to be a little bit... I think they're 49 and 50 all. Oh, 48? Okay, that's good. These things, if you look careful... I don't want to fight those. I want to fight these. Yeah, there we go. Wait, who is this? Where's the... What is a 43? Man, I think I'm kind of the level to be out here. Well... I'm trying to see if I have anything I need to worry about. Okay. I don't think I need to worry about that hunter. I do want to kill this thing, however. So yeah, these are much easier. The stingers, I think, are a lot easier to kill than the than anything else out here. Like the big guys, these, I don't know what he's called, the swarmers, they spawn like little guys that are quite annoying to deal with. So you really don't want to mess them if you can help it. Resist, yeah. But these guys are kind of squishy too. They have like relatively squishy anyway. Ooh, I don't want to fight this guy. Get him off me. Okay. Well, I used up a ton of mana there, which wasn't the best thing ever. There we go. At least we got one centipar part. This is what I'm hoping. It should just be a few quick kills to get these. Workers. I don't think the workers drop them. I think we have to kill... Alright, let's just kill this guy. What is going on? Okay, 11 and 12 nature damage inflicted every 5 seconds. Got it. Resist. Oh, that's not good. It's really bad to start a fight with resist. It's like really, really bad. Why am I... Oh, Jesus. That's the thing. Oh, crap. That's really bad. Get it off me. Get it off me. Oh, God. These things are really, really annoying. Okay, we gotta get out of here. I'm trying to get away from this if we can. How does Tangmoth tank all that? It's incredible. So these are the problem, these little bugs, they hit so hard. They hit for like 40 damage each. I am just like literally going to sacrifice our guy. Oh man, look at the corpse of Tangmoth. Just, oh, it's sad. So those things are like, it's like, I guess ironic, they're bugged, I swear. They won't de-aggro you. I remember that the problem is with these guys. When I was doing this with my mage, the only way to de-aggro them is to kill all of the little bugs at the same time. And that's not... Like, the only way to do that as a warlock is do something like Hellfire. But I don't really want to start, like, damaging myself. Because if it... I don't know. It's just like I'm already low health. I don't really want to mess with it. I also didn't think about it in that moment of panic. I just kind of ran because I was really scared. So I think that's, like, the only way to fight these guys would be, like, a mage. Because I could... cast like Frost Nova and just like kill all those little bugs. They don't have a lot of health, they just do a lot of damage. But man, it's just annoying. So I don't like fighting those guys. It sounds like I'm whining here, but man, they're annoying to fight. They really are. And you can't tab to target those little bugs. They're not tab targetable for some reason. So they're just, everything about them is really annoying. It's really annoying. It's like the only way I can describe those swarmers are extremely annoying mobs to fight, so I generally am gonna avoid them. But we have these little stingers, thankfully, which are a little annoying, but certainly all they do, the only thing that these guys do that are actually a problem to deal with is they will they'll poison you, and that's not that big of a deal. He just resisted my death coil, so that kind of sucks. How hard do they hit me? They're not hitting me like that hard, I guess. I'm just wanding him down the last little bit here, I think, which is probably okay. Yeah, I think that's fine. What food do we have? Anything? Let's go ahead and eat one of these barbecued buzzard wings. Yeah, I can't bandage. That's the other thing. You can't bandage because this poison will take out you'll interrupt your healing about halfway through the bandage. So if you time it perfectly, as soon as the venom sting ticks, start your bandage, you'll get like 3 ticks of bandage heals. So it's about like, what is it? You're gonna lose about half of it. Eh, it's a little sad. But that's okay. We've got 2 of 5 centipar parts now. And I'm trying to decide. Okay, 48. I mean, in general, these are a little high level for us, so I'm kind of trying to focus on the, like, if I can, just like level 48 stingers. Like, you know, just to simplify life a little bit. Well, he resisted the taunt from Tangmoth, so I'm gonna get a fear off where he poisons. Nope. These attack really fast, too, by the way. Like, it's actually, you know, mind and also they were interrupting me quite a bit there. And they also don't apparently stay feared for very long. These guys are just giving me a hard time. I really am getting smoked right now by these guys. There we go. Nice. Okay. Not the worst fight ever. And that was a 48. That's the thing. They hit hard. They attack fast. They poison you. The swarmers have those little bugs they summon. These are tough mobs. Now, what's really funny is if you want to really have a fun time with these guys, go down here. I forget what it's called. This is the Noxious Lair. This is something similar. Go down to this little southeast quadrant. There's a tunnel system down there. We'll go down there later because we do have a quest we have to deal with in that area. We don't have to, but I will probably do. Because I think it's a fun quest, even though I'm complaining about it so much. It really is like a fun quest. Resist. But it's like closed quarters with these kind of mobs. So you end up getting... it's like swarmed, you get poisoned, it's hard to heal, you can't really run away very easily. It is a messy spot to be in, but I do have a lot of fun fighting it out. Like, it's kind of, it feels like a really fun little area to deal with, because there's so much going on down there. And man, I really wish I hadn't resisted my death coil. That was, not good. Alright, it's a race. There we go, we got him. No centipar parts of that one, unfortunately. And I didn't get poisoned. That's good. I'm gonna go ahead and bandage. Probably should use my mage rebandage. Probably needed it there. Okay, we're gonna try and find a few more of these stingers now. I'm so sorry for complaining so much right now. I feel like I'm being super whiny and negative about these bugs. Actually, I think they are well-designed mobs. I think this is a perfectly designed, you know, subsection within Teneris, because what you're looking at, you know, you don't want to fight mobs here. These are actually tough mobs. It's a well-defined zone, so you don't, like, stumble into them on accident. You might fall off a cliff here and get stuck down here, which is kind of unfortunate for yourself, but, you know, it's like a fairly well-designed little, I call it a sub-zone within a zone. I like it. But there's tough mobs, especially because I'm a little low level for them, but I'm really low level, right? I'm 4 or 5 levels below them, but I'm still going for it, because I know I can do it. It's totally doable. Most importantly, we're already 60% of the way through the quest, so it's going pretty fast, considering these are, you know, high-level mobs for us. I'm not really... Can't complain too much about all of it. Well, you can actually complain too much easily, but I'm gonna try to avoid complaining too much. Now, once we get this quest done, which I forget if this is a chain quest or not, and maybe I should just be fearing this guy all along, you know? Maybe that's my problem, is that I'm not just, like, slamming fear on him right away. I kind of get the feeling that fear is a little bit of a bad idea here, because they will run and go and mess with us with other... annoying mobs, you know, and I don't really want them to bring especially a swarmer at us. That'd be really bad. 4 of 5, so we're 80% done. Okay, so we need to get, let's see if we can just grab this guy from a distance. Just like run over here, throw a dot on him. Good, not resisted. That's perfect. Good. Nice, we got three spells in a row that weren't resisted by that guy. Can we get a fear? Nice, perfect. Although immolate, man, that direct damage really just nukes. Let's try this. I want to Shadow Bolt this guy real fast. I want to see... Oh, it resisted. Okay. Huh. I was going to say, in general, it feels like Shadow Bolts, or direct damage, really does break fear fast on this server. And even, like, Immolate. Like, I hit him with an Immolate, and he just popped right out of it. Just right away. Let's Life Tap once. Yeah, once is good. Okay, so we finished that quest, though. It went well. We didn't die. Nothing too crazy happened. Someone down here is complaining about someone in Silithus. In Silithus, by the way, is like Teneris senior. It's like the daddy of Teneris, I feel like. So Silithus down here, here's a fun story about Silithus. So it's the zone in the southwest side of Kalimdor, and it's level like 55 to 60 zone, high level zone. What's fun about Silphus is when WoW first launched, Silphus had nothing. I mean, it literally had almost nothing down there. There was the like Staghelm Point over here, and there I think Cenarion Hold did exist, but there was almost nothing there. I think it was like two quests. It was like seriously, almost like two or three quests only. I think there was a flight point. I'm pretty sure there's a flight point. This alliance and horde markings, those weren't there. The gates, I think, were there, but there was some detail that wasn't... like, they spruced them up quite a bit later on. But Silphus was literally like a dead zone. Level 60s, or like level 55 to 60 characters, they were trying to level up all the way to 60. 55, 59 characters, they wanted to hit 60. They really didn't ever go there. There was just no... There's nothing there. There were mobs. I mean, there were just like mobs that patrolled. There were like the little Silphus bugs and some sand crawlers, a few things like that. I think some scorpions, but there was nothing. It was just no point. So, if you were a level 55 character looking for a place to level, maybe Un'Goro, you could do a little bit there. If Un'Goro was probably really by 55, you probably were finished up there. Fellwood, you probably finished up by that point. Ezhdara, you probably didn't go there for 55 plus. You pretty much had, like, I think literally the only option, now that I'm looking at it, in Kalimdor is Winterspring, which is 55 to 60, definitely. Maybe you could stretch it and go up there by like 53, 54. And, by the way, we are heading east, and actually, let's go north back to Gadgetzan. Because I want to turn in a couple quests. I want to turn in that quest we just did there, and then go east over to grab a few more quests over here and turn in Stoli's Debt quest. I forgot about that quest. I was just looking at the map and realized I have that. So I'm going to go turn that in also. But Silphus just had nothing. And because Silphus had nothing to do at 55, in all of Kalimdor, the only zone you could level in, like, really, was Winterspring. There was nothing else here to level in Kalimdor for level 55. I guess... Were there even any instances? Dire Maul eventually came around as a 55 level instance. Honestly, Dire Maul is like level 60 instance. I don't really know people that went there that weren't at least 59, if not 60. Because there's a lot of good pre-raid gear there. But I guess I really never put this together, but there, once you're level 55, there was nothing to do in Kalimdor, in Vanilla WoW. I mean, before Ankh-Arash, before Silphus became a zone that actually had stuff to do. So the only place to level 55 plus in the open world was pretty much Eastern and Western Plaguelands, more so Eastern Plaguelands, and then, not Searing Gorge, I always forget, Burning Steps, and I think that's it, Blasted Lands a little bit maybe, but, that's right, Deadwind Pass. So, my train of thought changed as I started talking about this. The original point was, Silphus was nothing, it was pretty much an empty zone, but they eventually... obviously with the Ankh-Arash patch, when that launched the war effort, there's a lot to do there in Silphus. But even before that, a patch or two before, they started to change things a little bit there. Blizzard started to make some modifications that improved just stuff in general in Silphus. I forget, I honestly, unfortunately, don't recall exactly what changed before the Gates of War or the war effort patch. But they did quite a few things to start improving it over time. But the... I really hope this guy doesn't slow poison me. As I was talking about that, I realized there's nothing to do in Kalimdor for level 55 plus before that patch. At this point, honestly, even still, there's only Silphus, even post the Ankh-Arash war effort patch. I never really realized how much of a tilt or how much of a leaning there was for Eastern Kingdoms being the 55 plus leveling areas. It's honestly right, because you basically had Everlook, or it's not Everlook, sorry, Winterspring, Silphus. But over on Eastern Kingdoms, you had Eastern Plaguelands, some Western Plaguelands quests, and like I said, Burning Steps at least. I'm just like, this is like blowing my mind a little bit. And in terms of instances, you definitely, I would say there's more high-level instances on Eastern Kingdoms because of Strat and Shallow alone. Or not Shallow, sorry, Skulu, Skulamance. Hold on, change of topics here real quick. Noxious Lair Investigation, we're going to turn in this quest now, we just completed it, done. There is another quest, but we can't get it yet, I just am not high enough level, so we will leave that for the time being. Okay, That's, yep, yeah, good. Alright, we're gonna head east now. Dude, what quest is this? Oh yeah, we got that already. We dumped it. It's a Zulfurok Scarab quest. So, sorry, I feel like I'm really talking a mile a minute here, more than normal even. I apologize for all of the rambling at the moment. I'm gonna calm down for a second and explain what we're gonna do next. So, we're heading east because there is a little area over here, Steamweedle Port, and Steamweedle Port has never had a lot of things, but there's about 5 quests there that you can do, which is actually, I mean, relative to the size, it's a fairly significant amount of stuff you can do there. But we're gonna head over that way, and we're gonna turn in Stoli's Dead because we have that quest. We have the I thought we had somebody to turn into him. I guess we have to just talk to Stoli. So we're gonna talk to him. He's gonna give us another quest. He'll give us a follow-up quest. There's a little Kodo running around. Kodos are so cool, by the way. Anyway, so we're gonna find Stoli, turn in the quest there. He should give us another quest that I think will send us to a different zone. I'm forgetting exactly where that quest goes. I'm gonna do a couple things here real fast. Oh man. I put that restore life. This is our Orb of Dar Aura Hill on my toolbar, and I just hit the button thinking that was my Soulstone, create Soulstone button. That was not the smartest thing I've ever done. Small thorium vein. Can't mind that yet. So the reason why I was making a new Soulstone, so I had my mana would regenerate, and then in about 3 minutes when this one runs out, I would have a Soulstone ready to go, and I could cast it on myself. But I obviously mucked that up a little bit. No harm done. So here we are in Steamweedle Port, which there's nothing here besides this little hut and that little hut and that third little hut. And Stoli should be right in here. Little goblin, I think. Oh no, not a goblin. I thought he was a goblin. Everyone else is a goblin in here, except for Stoli. Let's complete the quest. We get 550 gold. Okay, Stoli's shipment. Okay. Yep, I know where that's where we gotta go for that. That's south of here. Available quest, South Sea Shakedown. Okay, I know that quest. We're gonna do that with the Stoli's Debt quest. That's perfect. Troll Temper, we're gonna abandon because this is a Zulfurok quest that we just get from Gadget's End. It's easy enough to grab. And we need to make a little bit of space for some of the quests here. Haughty Modisti. Modest? Pirate Hats. Oh man, this quest takes forever. We're gonna grab it. I don't think we're gonna do that quest though. It really is a long, long quest. What is in here? I haven't been in here in a while. General goods. Does it guys sell anything unique? He's literally just a straight up general goods vendor. Okay. Good for him. He's got a tall strider over here. He's got a little bear. It's kind of creepy. Okay. Well, we're gonna move along. And what do we got? Yeah, Kenya. Screecher spirits. Oh yeah, this is yeah, this is in Feralis, so we will need to go to Feralis to work on that quest. So we can ignore that for the moment, because we just don't need to go over there. There's really no reason to at the moment. What's the skill? 3 inches of fury. I don't know anything about that. Now, what I'm looking for is Firebeard's head. He's down here. And Caliph Scorpid's thing's head. Caliph Scorpid's thing is should be around here. And I think he patrols. He's a stealth guy, right? Okay, so we're gonna work on a few of these quests. What do we got here? Bandits, thieves. Okay, so we need to kill bandits and thieves right now. But I think I need to go a little farther south here. Where is this guy patrols? And we should see him with a few other people patrolling with him. Maybe he isn't stealth and the people with him are stealth. Trying to keep an eye out. I just want to like kind of scope it out. It's been a while since I've done this quest. I'm pretty sure he patrols. We are, by the way, in the Mountain Hut Adventurers Guild. I think I mentioned that a little while back that I was in some other guild. What was it called? I'm forgetting the name now. I have to look back and see what the name was, because the guild was like dead, deader than dead. And it was like me only ever online in the time that I was on anyway. So I left that guild and switched and found this guild, and they seem like they're a little more active, which is great for me. I'm happy with that. I'm not looking for anything crazy with the guild, but It is nice to have at least a few people online sometimes, in case you ever want to chat with someone. Okay. I don't see the guy right now, so we're just going to focus on killing... I don't need the shadow. Whoa. What is this? Rogue? Okay. I was like, is this the guy? He's like, that'd be great. Nope, not the guy. Let's go ahead and get our soul stone up before something does come up and kill me. Really don't want to die. I think, Dying, if you think about when you want to level and really talk about leveling efficiency, dying is one of the worst things you can do to level efficiently, right? I mean, it literally is a loss of experience because you're dead. You have to run back, and that takes a little while sometimes, especially as you might recall from last episode when I died in the Hinterlands, and I went ahead and just straight up rezzed because that was so far of a run that I didn't want to deal with that. I'm looking around here to see if I can... Okay, so it's saying the guy's head. He's actually back this way. So maybe he is a little bit farther south, and I'm just not quite there yet. I thought he roamed farther up than this, but maybe I was turning around too quickly. I'm gonna take a quick look. And hold on a sec. So we do have detect invisibility, but that's not what we need. So there is a... Is there anyone here? No. I'm just kind of looking around a bit. Okay, well maybe he's not here. He could very well be dead. And he just like patrols with people, so it should be pretty obvious if you see him. So I'd like to find him. It's such an easy quest. He's an easy kill for us. It wouldn't take long at all. But maybe we'll have to swing by here later if we clear up before we clear up all these mobs we need to kill. We'll come back down here and take a quick look. Anyway, so what was I saying there? I think we do have detect. Oh, whoa! Saw warriors pop in here. You don't think that warrior's gonna attack me, right? What is he? I see a basic. I don't think so. I think he'll leave us alone. Okay then. So what that means is we need to kill... Not thieves, we need... Oh yeah, we do need thieves. Okay, good. Yeah, so we got about 10, we got 20 kills here. It's gonna... Nah, they won't take that long. We got a few things we gotta take care of here. I'm wondering, these are solo level, if I can just dot them up, you know, pretty heavily here, and if that'll pretty much take care of them. Oh, there's also a druid there in the same guild, so we need to be careful with that. I don't want to get into a big fight with these guys. that guy sure is running fast. So some thieves, some bandits, okay. Sure, why not? Just let's aggro everything, it's fine. I don't really care. Ooh, I got Drained Soul off, like, I thought just in time, but not quite in time. The reason why I've been casting Drained Soul more, by the way, you might notice I have a lot of soul shards. And I think you probably know, but I... What is it? Finally specced into Improved Drained Soul, which gives me a 100% chance to get 100% increase for mana regeneration for 10 seconds if the target is killed while I'm draining their soul. At least in theory. But it doesn't always work, and I don't know why yet. It's just like randomly, it doesn't do it. So, I don't know what the deal is with that. But that's okay. It's still like this. 100% mana regeneration increased. Or 50% can continue to occur while I'm casting, which is also super good. Yeah, I wish there was a way to do AoE dots. Like, I wish I could target all these mobs and just, like, auto-cast my entire cycle of dots. That would be pretty handy, I think. But that's not doable for a variety of reasons. Probably largely due to balance concerns, because I couldn't imagine in PvP, if you were a warlock and you could just go into a group of alliance, if I was a an orc warlock, and just cast AoE on all of them instantly, that would feel really good for me and really bad for them. We're gonna get... Can we not... That guy's like bugged, it looks like. We can't actually target him. So that's kind of annoying. We're gonna move over here and kill some other people instead. Yeah, there is some I don't know if it's well known, but fairly common bugs with these structures. Like, you just notice that one thief just like jumped off this tower. For whatever reason, they get stuck on the towers in weird ways. And the other thing that happens is these little huts, they get stuck in the center. Like, they spawn inside of those boxes and the weapon racks and things. And then you can't target them. Or they get stuck, or you can target them, and then you attack them and they go immune and they won't ever come out. It's just, it's some weird stuff going on there with those. And I don't really know if that's always been the case. I don't remember that in retail vanilla being a problem at all. And but private servers, I've seen that in a lot of private servers. So that is a, for whatever reason, this is kind of a glitchy spot, and I don't know what the pathing problem is there. I'm really glad that this guy, he figured it out. He had to get in melee range. It works. You can kill him. It's not like it's impossible, but it is just a little messy. Okay, here's a little... Let's see if this guy wants to join up with us. He's gonna decline, I think. Killing bandits? Banditas? Let's see, bandits and thieves? Thieves? Plural of thieves. Plural of thief is not thiefs, it's thieves, like V-E-S, so I kind of butchered that, but nah. Life goes on. Now, I grouped up because I don't want these guys to wreck me. Now, I don't know why we're going... We go that way, there's stuff to kill, but... Yeah, I figured if we group up, it might have a little better of a shot at killing these guys. That's my hope. We'll see if that actually comes true. But it looks like they're not gonna... They seem friendly, it's nice. I enjoy friendly people when they are leveling. Like, it's, you know, it's always good to have more friends than enemies hanging out around you. Even if they're Alliance scum, I'll let them go on. I'll forgive them for being Alliance as long as they don't attack me. And I think we could possibly take them in a fight, but it wouldn't necessarily be the easiest of things. We do have 4 of 5 now of those water pouches, and these water pouches, that's a whole other quest we're working on, which is a very easy quest, obviously. These water pouches, actually, once you turn them in, you get a little crate that has a few potions in it, I think health or mana potions, one or the other, and then some food sometimes. That's not like the best thing ever, it's like a little care package. I think it's like called a Gadgetzan Water Company care package or something. But what is nice is you can actually repeat the quest if you want, and I think you get reputation with the Gadgetzan. And I think you get, what else do you get? I think that's it. I don't think you get experience. I think you literally just get reputation and then the items that come with it, of course. Hey, there's Caliph. There's Caliph. Perfect timing, my man. Not perfect, but good enough. Is he being escorted by anyone? I don't see anyone. Huh. Okay, maybe I was wrong. I could have sworn he has 2 little stealth guys that come with him, but... I'll just kill this guy as is. I'm fine with that. Can I share this quest? Oh, hey, this guy's got the quest too. Perfect. Hey, you wanna get that mob off me? Let's go ahead and... I'm just gonna put some dots on these guys just to heal up a little bit. And... loot that head. Perfect. That's what I needed. I'll be back in 2 minutes. Okay. I don't know when he said that, if he just now said that, but... works for me. I'm just gonna keep killing the mobs. I only need bandits at this point. I need 7, so I'm gonna try and kill them. And I'll try and kill them close to this guy so he can get credit. Oh, what's his name? Borivo? I don't know how you pronounce that name. I never know how to pronounce any name. If you've watched my channel, you probably know that by now. It's... sure agreed that. Okay, we just need bandits, though. So these are all... there's a bandit. There's a thief. Any bandits? A bandit. Nice. Okay. Hey, we got a forge over here. We could even do an anvil. We could do some smelting if we wanted. I don't need to. I don't want to. Actually, I do need to smelt a few things, but not in any real priority. So we're going to get that guy going. And we're going to grab this lady over here. Throw down the good dots. Okay, perfect. And hopefully, I think, yeah, Tangmoth's got this, Tangmoth, that's his name. I do have it right this time. I finally am not calling him Sardok anymore, so good for me. It only took, like, months to not botch his name. They're a thief. I'm another thief, not a bandit. Now we're 75% done with this quest. We need some more bandits, though. Thief, 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 thief. So many thieves out here. What is the difference between a bandit and a thief? I would argue that a thief steals from someone. A bandit steals. I mean, they both steal. I was about to say they're both thieves. No, they're not both thieves. One's a bandit. They both steal things, right? But I don't actually know what a difference would be between a bandit and a thief. In fact, even in game, I don't know what the difference is between a bandit and a thief, because they don't seem to do much different, do they? Like, they kind of look like they're the same thing to me in terms of their attacks and abilities and spells and all that. See, there's an example. I didn't get my, I've complained about this a million times, and I apologize, but I didn't get my little buff for mana regeneration. I don't really know why. Oh well. Life goes on. Now we do have three more after this bandit to kill of the bandits. So we're getting our way through the bandit killing, which is great. And we've got the Caliph quest done. Caliph? Would you say Salif? I'd say Caliph. And the Water Pouch bounty quest done. So we're going to have three quests here to turn in pretty soon. We haven't really worked on our Gazridian ornaments at all. I've been ignoring them. I probably ran by a bunch, and you're probably, hopefully not freaking out too much, but people may be freaking out at the screen a little bit at my negligence of that quest. But that quest is so easy. Like, you will find those Gazridian ornaments by the time you finish all your quests here, so it's really not a reason to prioritize it. This guy really just AFK in the middle. Oh, he's got the Hekkar buff. Nice. This guy's super just, like, AFK in the middle of the worst spot. He AFK'd pretty close. Like, pretty freaking close to mobs that are... Oh, he's back. Never mind. I just realized he's back. I'm over here complaining about him. He's running around in circles. Anyway, we don't need this thief. I assume our buddy does need some, so we're going to go ahead and kill it anyway. We also aggroed it on accident, so I'm just going to go ahead and finish off. But, yeah, so pro tip, don't AFK in the middle of a spot where people are spawning, because you will probably die. Now, obviously, this guy is a little bit luckier and didn't quite die, so good for him. What do you need? What do you need now? I need two more bandits, so I'm going to grab a bandit for myself and just split up dots between all these guys. I think our friend over there should be just fine taking on the one mob he's got, right? Or two mobs? Yeah, he's fine. I guess I can keep doing this. Ooh, we got full health now. I love Death Coil. Death Coil is such a good spell. Like, so, so good. And here's the crazy thing. Death Coil, I do know this. One thing I learned, I think this is still true. Death Coil is no longer a Warlock spell. It became a, Mistscape Bracers. 8 intellect, 3 stamina. No, we don't need that. Greed. Death Coil became a Death Knight spell, I think, in Wrath of the Lich King. It's a really good spell, so that probably really sucked for Warlock players. Like, I don't know what's the equivalent as, like, a rogue, but that's not a fun spell to lose. I mean, it's a good spell. It's a really good spell. I would argue that, can I get this guy now? There we go, maybe? He appears stuck. Well, here's what we're gonna do. If you get in here in melee range, then you can actually hit this guy properly. Now, what's funny is the guy on the outside here is stuck too. Like, they can't get in here to attack me, so it's like kind of a safe bubble. I don't know if it works for PvP. I want to test that now. Like, where are those guys? Can I? I can't reach him from here. I was gonna say, it'd be really nice if I could find that guy and kill him from there. So one more thief and four more bandits. Okay, this guy, he's all done now. I think we will. Let's see, how do I want to do this? I'm trying to decide what I want to do now. I'm obviously not doing anything at the moment. I think I want to go turn in all these quests. We got 3 to turn in. I think there is a chain to some of this, sort of. Might be nice to go turn it in. So he needs a few more. I'm going to help him out real quick. He needs just a few more bandits, that's all. So I know I was just doing that, and I was trying to drag him closer to him, the bandits, but I couldn't quite get them all there, but Let's go ahead and finish up, help him out, and then we'll go turn in these quests in Gadget Zan. Actually, are you okay finishing on your own? I am all done. He really should be fine. He was fine out here without me. So I think I will leave him alone. But first, underwater breathing. Super important out here in a desert. Okay, thanks for your help and take care. And we're gonna go turn in our quest now. Yeah, so let's go turn him in. And then we're actually closing in on the end of the episode here, by the way. I wanna go turn in these quests, which are all, they're all in Gadget Zan. Sometimes they're over here in SteamWiddle Port and I mix up which one's which. Trying to avoid that. Ooh, a warlock. Wait, watch this. Yeah, there we go. Now I can't mount. Crap, what am I doing? Not worth it at all. Totally regret that. But hey, look how much damage we did to that guy. We took him down more than half his health, practically. Oh god. What level is that character? Oh god. I'm so sorry. What have I done? He's in raid gear. Guys, I'm so sorry. Oh no. I'm gonna get this guy. Oh no. Oh god. I'm so sorry. This is what I get. Oh no. Oh, karma. Such karma. That's really funny. That's really impressive. That's what I get. All I wanted to do was just mess with the guy a little bit. I wasn't really trying to, I'll give them the free kill. I thought they'd have fun with that. I got counterspelled. That was good. I wasn't really trying to kill the guy. I just was, you've seen I do that a lot. I dot people, just when I'm running around. It's kind of fun. And he wasn't like that low level that it was that mean of a thing to do. But what are the odds? What are the odds in the middle of Teneris that I dot some guy? I mean, actually not the middle of Teneris, we're near Gadget Zan, so that could be it. That I dot someone and he's running directly towards a raid gear level 60 mage. Oh man, and the soul stone at the end is, I might as well cast it. At that point, there's no reason not to. There's my corpse. Oh god, they're gonna camp me now, aren't they? I probably deserve that, but okay, so how do we get out of here? We got a timer. How do we escape from here? This is not going to be a far enough. He's got an epic mount too, that guy. So there's no way. What have I done to myself, guys? What have I done? Now, I'm thinking my best bet is to res back here. And then... what is the best way to do this? I'm just thinking about it. There's really no cover. We're going for it. Oh dear god. Now I will tell you, there is one trick here. If you're gonna die again, which I'm gonna die again, die somewhere that you can block line of sight. Such as this. Like if I die here, I can, there's a few spots I can spawn that'll put me kind of on, let's do this, go up here, there we go. That'll put me on either side of that mountain, I think. Which will make it a little bit harder for that guy. A little bit harder for him to camp me. We're gonna go to the other side here. I think this will work. This is like the epitome of video game karma. You know, you mess with someone's a little bit lower level that was seemingly minding their own business. And they bring in the big guns and wreck the crap out of you. Now we could escalate. I could see if anyone in the guild is around that would be willing to come out and help. Any number of things like that. But I think that this will probably be a little more fun just to try to escape. Now the goal here is to get to Gadget Zan. That is the mission here. It's just to mount and get to Gadget Zan. Now what I need to do is see, because I think I should be able... Oh man. Maybe I'm not quite close enough to do this. I thought that my spawn point, like where I died, that's not close enough. Dang, that's really bad. I thought I could res on this side of the mountain. If I can't res on this side of the mountain, then I'm a little more limited to what I can do. I've got a minute. Oh god, this is getting worse and worse. Now, where is this? Are they camping me still? They might have left me alone now. Or they're just like baiting me. But I'm trying to decide where would they be. Because what I think I want to do... Like, my guess is they're kind of just like waiting here. Like, right through here somewhere. You can't see things when you're dead is the other problem. It's always been a little bit tough. My guess is that they're waiting around here. And so they're thinking I'm going to go towards Gadget Zan. So... I think it might be safer to spawn... Yeah, this is not a good spot to die. I really thought I was dying. I thought you could rise through the mountain. Like, I thought I'd be close enough to the corpse. Apparently not. So I think what I'm going to try to do is get as far... Can I get up here and res? No. I think I'm going to res, like, right here. And cross my fingers. They may have just left me alone now after they got one extra... They killed me 3 times. I mean, I don't know how many times you want to kill someone before you're tired of it, but he got me 3 times. Okay, I don't see him anywhere. I was kind of like checking before I turn the corner here. Okay. So yeah, so my thought was that they might think that I was running around that way because I was trying to escape, which I was. Definitely was. Oh, it was an iron deposit. This is super risky, but I'm totally going for it. Totally going for it. Let's get it. I need these skill ups. It's so hard to skill up mining. You can't ever pass up a vein. If you see a vein as a miner, and it will give you an orange skill up especially, but even like a yellow or green, especially yellow, you need to get it. You just have to take it. It's just, there's just not enough mineral veins, I feel like, in vanilla in general. It's tough. So, okay. We might make it. Yeah, so I kind of had a thought that they saw that gap there, back there in the kind of top center of the screen, that gap between those two mountains. And I was thinking they might have thought I was going to go through that direction to try and get me. Like if they were camping out somewhere over there. So I thought I'd go around kind of south into the east of that mountain behind us there. Which maybe that worked out. I'm not totally sure. That sure added a little bit of fun though to our adventure. At least the graveyard was... that's about as close as a graveyard gets. I mean, I'm not complaining at all about the run from that graveyard. Why is there... Oh yeah, I put a flare. I was like, what is that? What is that like little... hangman thing doing there, sparkling it. The hunter threw a flare on it. That's what he did. Okay. Well, we survived the epic struggle to escape an epic geared, epic mounted level 60 mage that totally was like destroying us. Where do we turn in all these quests? Let's see. Okay, we can turn in the Waste Wanderer pouch or Waste Wanderer Justice quest here. That's good. Okay, now we gotta kill the Shadow Mages, Rogues, and Assassins. We didn't see the Assassins or Rogues, we did see the Mages, Shadow Mages there a bit. I didn't fight any of them. This is the Gadgets and Water Company Care Package. That's what I was talking about. Okay, we got 4,000 experience for that. And we're gonna turn in the Caliph Scorpid Sting quest, which we got 7,250. So, we just picked up, like, what is that, 16,250 experience? It's really nice. That's super solid. And here we can complete more of these Waste Wander Water Pouch quests if we want, but we don't have enough of the care packages just yet. Let's open this care package. Moonberry Juice and Moon Harvest Pumpkin. Those are totally fine, I guess. I don't know. Eh, we'll use them. And so let's see. Let me just recap a little bit here. Now what we're going to do next time, so we're going to wrap up here. Next time we can probably go work on more of these Waste Wander killing quests. What the crap? Well, my god. I was not... okay, well. What just happened? Ambush for 1,000. Ambush for 940. Hit for 100. Eviscerate for 150. Crippling Poison. And then he ambush crit me again for 930. How does someone... How did he do that twice? Oh, he must be preparation spec'd. So he was able to... Now this guy got sapped. Sad times. Well, anyway, and next time, what I'm gonna do is head over here to the east. Is this guy gonna die? How was this guy? Who hit me? Was it Norris? Oh, he did. He got, okay, so they got him. Norris, yes, was eventually killed. I was like, how's this guy still vanishing more? Good. Dead. Okay, so glad that guy's gone. What I was trying to say is next time we're gonna head east. We will maybe do this quest next, the more ways to wander justice, but I kind of want to work on the pirates. I like doing these pirates, and we've got, what is it, 1, 2, 3, 4 quests there, at least 3 that we will do very easily. The pirate hat quest we may or may not do, depending on our luck of our drops, but we're gonna head and do some pirates next time. So that's all for today. Thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you next time.